Today, people are connected to each other mostly through the internet. This can best be explained by today's top trend on the web, the doomsday. So what would have been an otherwise obscure brief in a newspaper is a top trend worldwide on social media. The world is celebrating the Mayan doomsday as its own. Therefore, that brings us to today's discussion. Doomsday, one thing you would want to change before the world ends. And here on Social Network, we would ask, replacing mainstream media with social media be a doomsday scenario? Now, before we open up the debate for discussion, a very important news that's just come in. The Home Secretary has now announced, in the wake of the recent gang rape and of course the actions taken, the Home Secretary has announced that all discotheques and bars in Delhi to be closed by 1 a.m. Now, of course, that raises several questions about whether of course that would really be a preventive measure or not, but we come back to that in just a bit. First, let's listen it to Vali Singh Rai, who sends us this video blog.
If I was to choose between mainstream media or social media, I think it's a no-brainer. One will have to go for social media because it's more independent and democratic, and people are more likely to have control of it once the world ends.
All right, we're joined now by Rahul Dev, who joins us from Delhi. He's a senior journalist. Anoop Trivedi, who's a theatre actor, joins us in the Delhi studio. Thank you, Anoop, for coming in. And also, Porush Jain joins us from Bangalore on that particular discussion. Just before we slip into the debate, Rahul, sir, your first thoughts on this announcement by the Home Secretary of shutting the discotheques by 1 a.m. Do you think that really serves the purpose, Rahul?
It serves a purpose, but in a limited manner. It won't completely save our women and solve the whole problem. So this is a small step, but I think this is the right step given the situation we are in and the state of assaults on women in NCR. I think this is the least that needs to be done, but there's much more that needs to be done.
Porush, just want to take that question to you. What do you make of the Home Secretary's new announcements and new measures, in a sense, to try and protect the girls in Delhi?
I support the changes that he has brought in, I guess, because measures have to be taken from the government. They are on the back foot after this. Yeah.
ओके अनूप, आपसे पूछना चाहेंगे, होम सेक्रेटरी के अनाउंसमेंट 1 बजे के लिए है, मगर इस लड़की का जो गैंग रेप हुआ था वो तो कुछ काफी घंटों पहले हुआ था, तो ये किस तरह से एक प्रिवेंटिव मेजर हुआ?
मुझे क्या लगता है कि अगर हम बात कर रहे हैं इस विषय पे, और आज डूम्स डे की भी बात चल रही है साथ में, तो डूम्स डे तो उसी दिन था जिस दिन उस लड़की के साथ गैंग रेप हुआ, और दूसरा डूम्स डे निठारी कांड, इस तरीके के जो कांड है या जो घटनाएं घट रही है देश में, इससे बड़ा डूम्स डे हमारे लिए और क्या होगा?
So Anoop really making that point that, you know, it's not really about Mayan doomsday as it's being talked about on Twitter, but the larger focus really on the fact that these, you know, absolutely brutal incidents and crimes that take place are really, in a sense, a doomsday, a wake-up call in that sense. Rahul, I just want to ask you, do you feel the fact that social media is trending on a subject like that, which could otherwise be looked as trivial, especially in the wake of the environment, is perhaps a call that mainstream media needs to be more effective?
Yes, I think social media has sometimes helped the traditional media, sometimes it has inspired the traditional media, and sometimes it has sort of pressurized the traditional media into taking up issues in a particular manner and to be more offensive and more sensitive to a wider variety of citizens and their feelings, and how outraged they are. So it has complemented the traditional media and goaded it into action several times.
Porush, just want to bring you in on that. Do you think, had there not been so much outrage on social media, which I know you very vehemently support, do you think this outrage would have become as big as it has, in a sense, today?
Never it would have been bigger as it is. See, this is a social phenomenon, and this cannot be conveyed properly from a one-way medium like a TV or print, because you measure a phenomenon through the outrage of people. How will you measure a phenomenon through a TV or print? You'll have to measure it through web. Is it trending on Twitter? Are your friends posting it up, posting about it? Are your friends mailing about it? So I can't even imagine the outrage would have not been even measured if it was not for social media.